Oh, yeah, now we're back. Muted! Yeah, I was about to say, like, I also remember when like, all the IPA cards on Magic Online were actually, like, 100 ticks and more. I think for quite a while, those were actually the most expensive cards in history of Magic Online. I wonder how long it's gonna take Wizards to release a statement on own. You know, I think they actually, they might, you know, the way I think it might have been handled is they basically blacklisted him for the event and they were like, okay, anything else we're gonna figure out afterwards. Because it's like, it's quite a big thing. IPA, well, it stood for Invasion Plane Shift Apocalypse, which was the first set that was released on Magic Online. And at that point they hadn't figured out how to like distribute cards, so it was only available for a short time. Yet everybody wanted like Chant and Deed because those were like big cards from the set, so they became really expensive. So yeah, so I think like maybe they're like, okay, we're gonna blacklist you and then anything else you're gonna deal with afterwards because this is way too big for us to focus on. So they might be like, okay, now this week we're gonna figure this out and we're gonna also see whether this is gonna have implications for like Magic Pro League and everything. So they might not even know themselves what they're gonna do with him. I wish we could play like all of our 1 mana cards in the first turn. Imagine if that was like a new rule. On the first turn you can play all your 1 mana cards, on the second turn you can play all your 2 mana cards and so on. I think most games would just be over on the first turn. People would go like, I don't know, Dark Ritual, like on the first turn all your 1 mana spells are free? Right, yeah, I guess you don't want to play that. Is this gonna be... You know what, we're actually gonna run out the Mothers. Because we can, I'm pretty sure we can get Stoneforge plus equip next turn, and this way we actually get to protect our creature that we're gonna equip. I could be wrong though. But I think they don't have Swords of Plowshares since they didn't kill the Noble Hierarch. Well, they do. Ooh, they might be better than we thought. That's called Hearthstone, except they don't have good cards. There's some combo on Hearthstone. I've literally never played Hearthstone. I'm only like 60% sure I know how the rules work. But I think there used to be a combo deck in Hearthstone that I heard about. So what if I get... I can run out Chitta, but I can't do anything with it. Might still be worth it. Also, let's not expose Cradle. Genie in a bottle. Actually, I could have equipped Chitta, but only on Mother, so that wouldn't have really done anything. Free, baby. Should I attack with the Dried Arbor? Actually, the thing is, if I attack with the Dried Arbor and he blocks, then next turn he gets 2 Swords to Plowshares as my Mother, so I would trade, like, Dried Arbor and Mother for Thalia and Swords to Plowshares, and I'd rather not do that. Misha's Factory. Oh well, there goes Mother. Well, they can't sort of purchase anyway. There's Thalia. Go ahead. Oh, he's gonna name Chitta, right? Ah! Where's my Knight of Autumn? Oh, the attack is really weird. The attack is really weird because he's gonna lose Thalia. Or is he? Oh no, because when a creature regenerates, it's removed from combat. Oh, opponent didn't realize, right? Oh, but the creature is not going to regenerate. It actually has protection from white. Oh, this is so weird. Upon the shame conceit, I'll take it. I'll take it for sure. Any spoilers exciting me thus far? No, there's no spoilers that are exciting me. I think that we've seen a couple playable cards, like the almost strictly better Diabolic Addict. It's not exciting me, but I think it's playable. It also gets rid of Leowald without making them draw a card, which is nice. I even think the uncounterable negate might even... It's probably not gonna see play now, but... In my head, I'm like, maybe Miracus players are gonna play like 1 or 2 to stop like show and tell. Like, people are like, yeah, but they're gonna play Busicho. Yeah, right, but they only play like half of them, not even half of them plays like a 1 of Busicho or something. And the new Teferi at 3 mana, I think that's a solid card for the Mirror Match. For like Miracles and Sideboard or similar decks. But I don't see it like as a main deck card. That Attack of Shame. You know what? The opponent actually probably had Swords of Plowshares and realized too late that he can't cast it. Good, yeah, good. Like, good always, of course, depends on what you mean with good. I think it's okay. I think it might see play. It probably will see play, and even for more than just, like, the initial hype, but I don't see it as a main deck card. What do you think of the Teferi Om's Jump Scepter lock? Nothing. I don't think that doesn't strike me as something that's probably good. You know what's one of the most beautiful cards? Like, this is one of the very few cards where I can dig the non-original artwork. Like, this in foil? So what's the opponent up to? Gonna run out the knight. I hate that I'm running out the knight, but just have to hope it sticks. And right now the opponent... Oh, okay, it's gonna kill it. At least we got the one-for-one trade. Okay, swords. Huh, what's our plan here? We can kill swords. I'm just like trying to figure out what else we could do. It's gonna be interesting. We could also like... We can either get knight or we can get Kusali Pride Mage. I think we do get Kusali Pride Mage. Not knight. We either get Kusali Pride Mage or knight. Upside of Kusali Pride Mages, we still make them spend the mana on the sword and even attack with the mother. Which is actually super awkward. Upside of the knight is we get to keep the knight. You could also wasteland them, but that's not really doing anything. I mean, technically we could like... Nah, there's nothing really great we can do. Yeah, knight is the obvious play. I'm just trying to figure out whether there's anything else I wanna do. The Nile is actually a little scary, but they only have one card in hand. Okay, so the fact that the opponent only has one card in hand actually makes me wanna like go for the power play. Where is it? Don't accidentally get the wrong knight. Romario! How's it going, man? Romario, are you actually following Brazilian football? Like the league? What's your favorite team? Like, when I was a kid, I thought like everybody in Brazil loved Santos. Because that's what the team Pelé played for. Oh, well, would you look at this. Opponent got us pretty good. Oh, getting Kusali Pride Mage would have been insane. Kusali Pride Mage would have been insane here. Okay. You live, you learn. O-ring, maybe? No. Okay. Oh, this is bad now. This is really bad now. This card's so good. And opponents out of cards, you would think that we could eventually find a way to beat them. But doesn't really look like it. Copa Libertadores. So maybe we just sit back and hope to draw something, because we really can't do all that much here. I guess technically we could have wasted the canopy. I actually didn't recognize the artwork. For a moment I was like blind by its glory. Oh, they are? Yeah, Corinthians, they're interesting, I read about them. Isn't it like they... Oh, was it Corinthians? No, I think that's a different team. That won Copa Libertadores like many, many times, but only won like the league in Brazil like a couple times. Like very few times. Or was that like an Argentinian team? No, that was like an Argentinian team from Buenos Aires. Or actually from a suburb of Buenos Aires. But not Rosario, but a different one. But I can't remember. My mother, no? But we're gonna sit back and have him, like, pump his Chitta as far as he can. And then we need to find, like, a removal spell for Chitta. But all the while he's also drawing cards and we're not developing our board. Yeah, really should have gotten that Quasari Pride Wrench. We might have still lost because he has mother. But might have been easier. Oh, the old boys. Allegedly, you know. Allegedly, Teferi, I was about to say no. Messi has a clause in his contract that he gets to always get out of his contract at Barcelona when he wants, in case he wants to join Newell's Old Boys. This song reminds me so much of grinding Diablo 2 back then, like in 2002. I grinded so much Diablo 2 back then. Nah, I'm just taking it. Sorry about Bayern, where... You mean the Champions League or the Bundesliga? I'm hearing this song a lot. You know, every time, like, things don't really work out for Bayern, it doesn't bother me that much, because I feel like, okay, this is giving us all the more reason to buy better players again. But at the same time, I don't even care about, like, the way I see it, like, football, European football, is headed into even more than it already did over the last couple of years, into a state where, like, there's gonna be, like, these super rich oil clubs that are, like, owned by a country. And then there's gonna be clubs like Bayern, like Barcelona, that are, like, still owned by their fans, and that's the team that you compete with. What's this gonna be? Oh, this is fine. Because in the long run, like, you, even though PSG and Man City haven't really done super amazingly in the Champions League yet, I think you can't keep up with those, and then you're, like, more proud of being what you are, which is, like, a team that's owned by its fans. Which is super, super cool. Which doesn't really exist in, like, for example, in American sports, I guess, except for the Green Bay Packers. Okay, now he's cashing in. Yeah, I think the Bundesliga and the Premier League are pretty good at, like, marketing themselves internationally. I'm actually not even sure what I'm looking for at this point. Like, not even sure what I would draw. I guess O-ring would be okay. They don't have, like, Flickervisp or something. Oh, that's fine. Well, Knight. I think at this point we might as well just call it quits. Let's try next game. Yeah, I can see the salary cap thing. Like, in general, I actually don't hate the American system of sports. Like, I think it's actually kind of cool the way it works. The only thing I dislike about it, but that might be necessary for it, is that, like, teams are not, like, fan-owned. That teams, like, the teams you have in American sports, they're not clubs in the traditional sense of the word, like you have clubs in Germany, or, like, other European countries, usually. Or not even European countries, like, globally. They're, like, people say, I first thought it was, like, a joke, like... When they call them franchises, I felt like, yeah, okay, you call them franchises because, like, you wanna mock the fact that they're, like, teams owned by corporations or, like, millionaires or something. But apparently they actually are franchises, and, like, for many years I thought it was, like a way to make fun of them. So, yeah. But at the same time, like, yeah, like you mentioned, right, not having relegation is actually hurting US sports, and, like, at least US football on an international level. No, we're not playing Tower of Megastrat. That would be quite the mirror break if you can get it to stick. So what's the plan here? We could really try to blow out the opponent if he really ends up having Swords to Plowshares. By just playing a land and passing, and he'd be like, okay, I want to use my mana optimally, so I'm going to start Splotches, end of turn Dryadaba, and then we're like, haha, Flashback Strictbreaker. But I think in the long run, it's still better to get the Stoneforge. But in that case, I should still attack first. Technically, I can get the Scriptranger and the Stoneforge if I was willing to give up a land drop. But I'm not. I don't give up land drops. I like mana. Mana is just my thing. I think there's just two things in Legacy at the core. Either cheating on mana or cheating on, like, oh, what do you call it? Basically, I'm saying your deck needs to be unfair or it needs to have acceleration, because at the core, both are the same. And you gotta do one of those if you play Legacy. By the way, Romario, who's your favorite Brazilian football player right now? Berascal. Oh! Ah, but I can't do that. In your hand. Also, I don't need to do it. Oh, this is gonna be really hard for the opponent to beat. I somehow have a stop in my beginning of combat step. What? No, I don't. I want to attack. So I was like, actually, should I keep a count on the Chitta in case he has Mother? No, because we have Swords of Plowshares for the Mother. So the only thing that gets us here is like a creature with like Hexproof or Protection from White or something. Even Relic Water. Oh, Relic Water, we're beating so hard this turn. I don't like that we actually end up sorting it, but I think that's okay. In your head, in your head, they're still fighting. And you know what? I'm gonna do it like this so I can eventually flash in that Scriptranger. Okay, this is gonna be pretty good for us here. Six cards in hand, four lands in play. There's so many things the opponent can do that could go wrong, and yet he only plays another Chitta. Which would have actually been okay a couple years ago. Actually many years ago. Yes, you got that. But you will not like it. Chitta, sure. I almost wanna do something else, but I think it's okay. There goes the knight. And with the knight, we're gonna destroy that revoker. Get out of here! 1, 2, 3 mana I can... Nah, there's no point. I'd rather have Sigarda next turn. Should I have used the Chitta counter? No. Because I already knew that I was gonna blow up the revoker. You like Coutinho or Firmino? Oh, you think Coutinho is gonna like leave Barcelona? There's been talk about him going to, like, everybody talks about, like, if you don't know where somebody's going, they might be going to Juventus. Somebody on Reddit like analyzed the current situation. He was like, ironically, the best club for him to go to would be Liverpool, but obviously he's never gonna go back to Liverpool. I mean, Bayern could actually use it, but we are never gonna pay so much mana. It's like, how much mana is he? He's like 120 million mana. It's like, okay, we have an infinite combo, no problem. what's happening over there? That's fine. Oh man, we can do so many things here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Oh, wow! Ah, oh, we're 1 mana short of getting Sigarda. Ah, it's okay though. We just do this thing. Do we get knight? I'm not even sure if we wanna get knight. I think we just wanna get, you know, we wanna get rasende, reifenlose Vollgarten, tireless tracker. Once again, a game where we're not getting Sigarda. But this is basically baby Sigarda. we already have like our own best friends combo online. Yeah, but even Cataclysm like would be really bad for them here, wouldn't it? And we won. What's the price of Kirby? 120? Eric is just such a beast. 31 trophies? Like, I liked how Aram and Lewis actually like tried to compete with him, and then Eric was like, you know what? I'm just gonna go back to like playing Reanimator and just gonna grind you guys out like crazy. 31 trophies. When the next best guy has like 19? You have neighbors, Mark? I imagine like every person in Denmark to like live in a small hut by the sea, and in the morning you guys go out and you go like fishing and you sing like Danish songs, then you greet the Swedes over there, and then you show the finger to the Norwegians, and then you come back, and then, I don't know, you play some guitar. Oh, you do? Yeah? See? I knew you would do that. I should probably know what this guy plays because I've seen him before, but this deck is so cool. When you don't have to mulligan, Magic is so much fun. Mulliganing is the worst. This is how we do it. Let's get the basic, even the nice looking basic. Let's run up my favorite card, not Magic Noble Hierarch. Thuggy Man's Trophy is crazy, right? How much cash is that? Actually, it used to be much more once when they paid a lot for the trophies. Black Red really made up for the chests, I mean. Like, when you see Blood Saint Maya with the ugly art into Badlands of the ugly art, can it really be anything other than Black Red really made up? Like, those guys, they don't care about anything. They don't believe in anything. They're like nihilists. Like in, you know, like the Big Lebowski. Oh, we're so close to getting Ooze online. If this was like Quirium Ranger, we'd actually have Ooze online. But we can't. So we're not getting Ooze online. I guess we could get Gardok Tick, but that doesn't really do anything. It stops like Unmask, ho ho ho. I mean, there's a world where they didn't draw one of their like 12 free animation spells. And if they actually end up whiffing, then we are probably winning the first game. Noble over Mom, Noble always, almost always over Mom. Acceleration is just so insanely important in Legacy. If anything, if he was playing combo, I'd be more inclined to actually play Mother first. At least not with a hand like this, because we had Senate for the Preacher, for the combo, anti-combo Hate Bear. But if they're a combo and you have like a Hate Bear in hand that you can cast second turn, then you usually want to play Mother over Noble Hierarch. So, since we have Scavenging Ooze already in play, and Grizzlebrand alone might not actually be enough to beat us in the first game, where they usually can't remove Scavenging Ooze, I'm actually gonna keep playing. Because we can actually infinite block Grizzlebrand, and we have, like, he needs to reanimate something now. Because if he doesn't reanimate something now, Grizzlebrand is all he's ever gonna get in the entire match, and that's not gonna be good enough. So he needs to do something now. And next turn we can actually attack for 4 guaranteed already with Mother. So if we draw, like, if he doesn't have anything here, and also doesn't discard a creature, like, if he discards a creature, then he's dead. But even if he doesn't, then we have, like, any Senate wins the game, any Noble Hierarch wins the game, Caracas wins the game, Caracas. But we still need him to, like, not reanimate something here. By the way, something is wrong with my thing that tells you which song I'm playing. This is not semi-charmed. Can't rely on. Pond actually. Ooh! Where is it? Spotify. What? Where's Spotify? Spotify desktop? Yes. Oh, and he already discarded a creature, so I think he's just dead on board. Did he actually manage to beat the Grizzlebrand? Bam! So now we're gonna like grow the use to 4/4, protection black, sack attack, protection black, GG! Yeah, I also think I won. Unless he has like, I don't know, instant speed reanimation on our upkeep or something. Actually, even that doesn't work. Technically, he can discard something in the end step that triggers from the graveyard, which means that players get priority again, and then he can like, yeah, whatever, okay, didn't happen. Yep, let's just get the Stoneforge, let's grow this boy, this Uzi boy. Let's get a Grizzlebrand. And while we're at it, what else are we gonna get? Let's get Faithless Looting. Let's provide the illusion of choice. And here we go. Black. Okay, now I just need to click the black thing. Black. Sack attack protection. Black. And take 5. We managed to beat the turn 2 Grizzlebrand.
This is how we do it.
Combo whore.
Easy. Okay, now we actually have some cards that we can bring in. This for sure. Like all of this goes out. 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 Swords probably goes out. I'm actually not sure though. Like 3. I wonder whether Swords or Oblivion Ring is actually better. Like Tireless Tracker and Excavator probably also not good enough. Like all of those cards are like pretty marginal. Tireless Tracker, it can beat a little bit. Can actually draw cards, which might be good enough. So what's in competition for the extra slot? It's, you know, sometimes they just get those draws where they like put, I don't know, Chancellor of the Annex into play and you're like, okay, I can actually maybe beat that. Usually turn 1 Grizzlebrand you're not beating a lot of time. But Chancellor, you can. Yo, Romario. I just love it when people go like, yo. Because in German, like, if you go, yo, and then a name, that's like, it's a very gangster thing to do. It's like, yo, Bushido, Alter. What's up? but Excavator might really not be it. Excavator, my god. Just like Prime Mage because it's extra beats. Don't hate that. If it was flying, it could also fog Grizzlebrand for a turn. Just, what does Oblivion Ring do better than Swords of Plowshares in the matchup? Not really much, does it? I guess Oblivion Ring takes out without the life gain, but yeah, that's not very good. Let's go with this. Experimental Frenzy Doomsday! What's going on? Oh, got this. Put a mulligan to 6. We're getting so many chances at finding Surgical. Like, this hand is actually okay. It even has like a decent curve. But there on the play. Nah, it's... Oh god. Please mulligan to 5 opponents, because otherwise this is gonna be tough. This is basically the first hand, just a little verse. You're from Switzerland shouting yo is not really gangster? Okay. Yes, Hammer is awesome in Germany. It's like, this is Hammer, das ist Hammer. Actually, you know what? We can actually listen to that song. Where's that song? Oh god, how would I find that? It's probably gonna be blocked on YouTube and people are gonna hate me. There it is. I'm gonna mulligan. Okay, no, I'm gonna keep. Is that the deck? looks like the opponent. Maybe they go like. This is how we do it. Let's just make sure not to lock us out from our own surgical with Thalia. Bewegst in dem Outfit, Hammer. Ich hammer. Übertrieben, Hammer bist, warum bist du nicht geblieben? Ich hammer, dass du nicht so viel Scheiße laberst wie die anderen, die sich auf den Partys immer nur an meinen Arsch klammern. You know what? I'm actually not gonna run with Thalia here because it's not Hammer, it's Hammer, like Hammer. But it's an A instead of the ER. That's what you do in German if you're like cool. You replace the ER in the end with an A because it sounds similar, but it's like more blunt. It's not like... The proper German word is Hammer. Hammer. But if you go like gangster, you're like Hammer. Hammer. Hammer, wie du dich bewegst in dem Outfit. Hammer. Unglaublich, Hammer. This is so much giving away what we have, but who cares? Nicht geblieben, bist Hammer. Bewegst in dem Outfit, Hammer. Thanks. You know, I almost would have a hammer here. Like, I recently had a hammer to do something else. It would have been awesome if I was like, hey, Julian, what's your stream gimmick? It's like, yeah, you know how Jan van der Vecht, he used to have a spell and everything. And Kenji used to have his, I don't know, Kenji thing. And I would be like, well, Julian has a hammer. Like, whoa, he does, yeah. And he smashes stuff with it every time something happens. The Boston accent. You know, Boston, apparently, like, they pronounce stuff in like, there's... The way I love learning about weird accents in the US is when they tell you these two words are actually pronounced the same in Boston. And you're like, what? there's some interesting shit there. Script Ranger. Oh, Script Ranger is amazing here. Script Ranger makes it so that we can actually play Knight. In dem Outfit, Hammer. Dich unglaublich, Hammer. Übertrieben, Hammer bist. Warum bist du nicht geblieben? Playing it pre-combat like a scrub. Hammer, einzigartig, unglaublich, Hammer. Übertrieben, Hammer bist. Bist du nicht geblieben? But okay, so to learn more, like, this stream is also about learning about American culture. What are the nicest sounding dialects in the US? And what are the ones that get ridiculed the most? Like, speaking about national dialects, not like foreign accents. So, back to our 90s list. So, what's the protocol? You know what we should do? What I should have done? You know what's gonna happen? I should have bounced at Savannah in the upkeep so he can't massacre me. Oh, he's gonna unmask. Himself! Okay, go ahead. Do it. Ashen Rider. And now you're gonna pay, like, I don't know, 3 mana for Axiom? Good luck. Like, I almost don't wanna, like, remove it because we can probably beat Ashen Rider. Ah, okay. But we're gonna do it. Texas gets made fun of a lot. Yeah, but Texas, isn't it like Texas supposed to be this strong country? Strong country, yeah, I guess they wish. The strong state that everybody's like, oh, Texas is so tough, Texas is so tough. The Californian Valley girl? Oh, that's actually cute, isn't it? Yeah, the southern accents are like... By the way, we won. Is it like 41-10 now?
Something. Don't kill!
Are you not entertained? Didn't I promise you that this deck is like really good right now? Yeah, isn't it in the South also where they call everybody honey? Honey and sweetie and stuff like, if you go to a restaurant. Yeah, that already happened to us in I think it was Virginia, Richmond. When we went to a diner and like the waitress, not old, but like 50 or something. And she called us honey. Honey, I don't have that, I'm sorry. When we ordered something for the menu that she ran out of, she was like, oh honey, I'm so sorry. Like, did she call us honey? That's so weird. Darling. Oh. Does German have a word for y'all? You mean like something that's associated with like country people? Huh. Actually, I gotta imagine it in my mind. What would somebody from like deep, deep Niederbayern, like rural Bavaria, if they encountered a group of people, they would be like, is? Yeah, actually, that's what my relatives in like rural Bavaria use. If they try to address a group of people, they will be like, "Es, kommt sie her? Kommt sie her?" Actually, like my area. Anyway, that's too deep. Another one of those. Ah, see, but this guy or girl, Småland, isn't it like a region of Denmark? No, Småland, that's what they call the kindergarten area in IKEA, right? Småland. I got close. So, do we Wasteland and try to beat him that way? It's probably super unlikely to work since he Faithless Looting already. But there's a chance he only has like one land. I don't hate Wastelanding, it gives us an out. Whereas like, even if we play Birds of Paradise, what are we gonna do next turn? Nothing. Like, run out Thalia? I guess Thalia plus Wasteland could also be... It's basically the same thing, though. What? They use Yawns? Is that, like, you younglings or something? I don't see you. Thanks for tuning in. You know what somebody should do? Somebody should have like a really old school, really... Oh, look at this. Well, I guess we could have done this had we played... but we would have shuffled. Anyway, somebody should put together a really, really old school... I actually shouldn't show the opponent what I'm playing. They might think I'm... Yeah, we're not beating this draw, by the way. So let's actually not show them what we're playing. You already showed him Fetchland, that was bad. Somebody should put together a stream, but they're like super old school Southern. They're gonna have like old school Southern apple pie, and they're like, you know, the meme would be they always invite everyone to come like to their home. They're like, yeah, hey, Alter, how's it going? Yeah, sure. I guess they don't say how's it going in the south, right? And they would be like, yeah, if you come to my area, I will invite you. I will treat you well. Yeah. Like this whole Southern hospitality thing. They should do that, but they never tell anyone where they live, and they just always ignore the question. That would be super cool. Let's try this. Give you up. Use guys? What? Yuns? That still sounds weird to me. Going on. Can we beat this guy? Let's have a decent opening hand. Oh god. Actually, okay. Now I saw the Noble Hierarch. I think it's actually decent. Let's draw a land next turn. Understand. Oh, don't get me started on the way Americans refer to soft drinks. Like, you guys have, like, pop, coke, and soda. And I think there's even another one. And, like, the soda one, that's actually always getting me. Like, that's by far the most common one I've ever heard. Like, I knew about soda way before I knew about pop and coke. But it was so confusing, because on the internet, you would read, like, people on Reddit would post, like, oh, yeah, you know what, people shouldn't drink as much soda. It's, like, really bad for your health and stuff. Well, in German we use pups, but anyway. So people are like, you shouldn't drink soda, it's really bad for your health and stuff. And like, you're sitting over here in Germany, and like, over here soda, that's like carbonated water. And like, apparently you have to say that, plain carbonated water. It's not like anything else. It's like mineral water, but it's like sparkling mineral water. I guess that's where I'm getting it. That's like what soda is over here. Which obviously is not like anywhere, like, bad for your health as, like, I don't know, Coke or Sprite or Fanta is sparkling water, right? That's, if you go to a German restaurant and you order water, you will get sparkling water. And if you go to a German restaurant and you order soda, you will get sparkling water. So having to realize that, like, in the US, like, soda is like Fanta, Sprite, whatever, it's like, oh, okay, doesn't make sense. But I guess it makes sense in the way that, like, Cola, Fanta, soda, whatever, that's also sparkling carbonated water, but they also put like the sugar and all that stuff in it. It's, yeah, that's many different ways, right? Water with gas, sparkling water, what have you. Come on, another Surgical. I guess we're gonna draw Script Ranger. Script Ranger wouldn't be the worst, but I'd rather draw Surgical. Script Ranger would be like free. Oh god. No, I don't know. Have to do it like this. We might be dead here, folks. Folks! Where do people say folks? Like, when I first learned about that word, I got it from, like, people who refer to their parents with it. Or, like, grandparents. Usually their parents, like, oh, the folks! The folks! I even can't say that, like, can't say that without, like, feeling stupid. I don't know. But where do people use that in the US? You'll order a beer just to be safe. Apfelschorle is fine, too. Apfelschorle. Actually, you should order Spezi. Honestly, if you come to Germany and you want to try something that they don't do in the US, order Spezi. Spezi. S-P-E-Z-E-I-E-I. Sorry. Yeah, I in the end. Oh, this deck, okay. Looks like we're getting Shadowgraved here. When my friends from the US were here for the first time, I always got them Spezi, and they loved it so much. And actually, like, they took the recipe back to the US and also made it a thing, because it's super easy to make. It's like 50% Coca-Cola, 50% Fanta, and Germans love Spezi. Folks. But folks sound so weird. You know what's the funniest to me? In Southern Europe, especially like in Spain and Italy, they don't call that, you know, that mono blue, usually mono blue deck that plays like fish creatures? We call it merfolk. But in Southern Europe, they call it merfolks. It's so funny. It's like the merfolks. It sounds like a TV series, like with Al Bundy, the merfolks. But apparently a lot of like online sites even like adopted that nomenclature, and they call it the merfolks. And this is the forest folks, and these are the desert folks. The mountain folks, oh, you can't forget about the mountain folks. Goblin folk. I mean, we have tree folk, right? But not tree folks. I guess we're losing this one. Combo whore! Opponent has 21 cards in hand. Not pescado, that's fish in Spanish. Hablo un poco español. He aprendido en la universidad. Oh, 10 años pasado. A mí me gusta jugar fútbol. Oh, ni fumisit parun. Volar. Este spell no poder poner counter. I don't know. Okay, wir lassen das mal. Okay, let's head to the next match. Can't win them all. I mean, combo, after all, is still one of the tougher matchups for Knight of the Reliquary. Crimson Daddy showing us the branch collection, what? You're dating a dryad. Oh, yeah. You're dating a dryad. And you visit her tree, folks. You lost to Aunt? Why would you do that, Mark? You shouldn't. You have Thalia in your deck. So do we. And we're gonna keep this. You know what? In this case, I'm actually gonna get a basic land. I mean, we have Noble Hierarch, so we can get around Blood Moon. I'm just, like, always manically scared of Blood Moon. I must have lost a game, like an important game to Blood Moon when I was a child or something. That's why I'm so scared. Oh, if this is gonna be Storm, then Thalia is gonna be great. And if it's not gonna be Storm, then Thalia is still gonna be decent. How do you actually date a dryad? Pass the turn opponent. No, now I'm gonna do it like this. There's a chance I might wanna get dryad Arbor eventually. Oh, you're right, it's an ugly land, right? So it might be Sneak and Show. But they apparently went out of their way to get the promo Ponda, even though I like the Fish Titty Ponda a lot more. You know how, like, a lot of cantrips actually have, like a theme of, how would you call that? Well, I want to avoid saying a sperm theme, but have you looked at, like, Ponda or the premium version of Serum Visions? Sneak, folks. Fish Titty Ponda is the best, just because it's from Lauren and the original art. Like, imagine you had, like, a really good friend, and then, like, a couple of years later, he gets reprinted. And he looks so completely different, and you're like, dude, what happened to you? It's like, oh, I got a reprint, now I'm, like, 3 moons Ponda. It's like, yeah, but then you're not my Ponda. Hashtag not my Ponda. Yeah, it's just thoughts. Just thought, okay. Well, I'd rather stay with the semen theme then. Also, honestly, Fish Titty Ponda is really, really cool because of this amazing flavor text. Isn't it like we see the same sky as you do, just through a different lens? Did opponent just pay 2 mana for Ponda? It's such a bad deal. That's almost like modern levels of cantrips here. Gonna do it like this, and I'm gonna try to play. Actually, I don't even need to play around anything. I have Thalia! Guardian of Thraben! Does anybody actually know what Thraben really is? I'm not that big on the lore these days. I know that she protects Thraben. But for like 2 or 3 years after she came out, I thought like Thalia was a cat. Because it looks like a lion that has turned into a human. Always original art. See, that's what I'm talking about. Oh, Thraben is a website. I had no idea. She's a guardian of Thraben, so like, she's like a virus defender or something. It's a city in Innistrad. Why does it need protection? And how does she protect? She like command an army. The high city of Thraben. On the northern edge of Gavony. What? Oh, it's a province, Gavony. Okay. Oh, that makes sense because there's Gavony Township, right? She's a Cathar. Cathar. Yeah, I really like the art. Thraben is our home, and I will not see it fall to this unhallowed heart. She's a pretty good creature. They should print her as an elf or something. I guess a human is fine. It needs protection from everything. See, that's what I'm talking about. Thalia needs protection from everything. That would be so sweet. Actually, is there any land that we can use to interfere with what our opponent's doing? Probably not. We can draw a card. It's not gonna be great, though. Imagine if you could get another Thalia. Technically, we can play Bardaskal, but then we're not using Knight to draw a card. But I guess in the long run, that's gonna be better. Yeah, let's do that. Actually, maybe we do more damage by just attacking. So what if I Wasteland myself here? Then I get a 6 Knight. Then I attack for 9. So taking him down to 7. And then I can kill with Mother, even if he puts in a creature. You know what? YOLO! This is our life now. This is what we're gonna do. This is how we do it. He goes like show and tell on us next turn. And puts in like Emrakul or something, then can still win. What? Thalia actually... Seppuku. You mean Sudoku? Thalia actually released Grizzlebrand? What the fuck? You know, the close-up Thalia actually looks pretty cool. I mean, I'm still like an original art Nazi. That sounds so weird in times where people actually hoard like old Nazi art. But you get the idea. But yeah, I like to call her anime Thalia. Because she looks like an anime. Liliana gave her a difficult choice. Door 1 or Door 2. Grizzlebrand or Door 1. You can get extra money if you pick Grizzlebrand. She's like, I could use some money, yeah! Everything's so expensive. Like, Thalia doesn't know. Everywhere she goes, everything like gets more and more mana expensive. And she's like, I don't know. People tell me you can get good bargains and good deals here, but I go there. It's like, it's 5 mana. No. Why would it be 5 mana? You told me it's gonna be 2. Between releasing Grizzlebrand or a bunch of people dying. Easy, a bunch of people dying. What the fuck, Thalia, come on. Everybody knows you do that. That's why Lily of the Way Ultimate... Whoa, okay, that's pretty cool. That's really cool, I had no idea that's how it worked. So what's the craziest thing the opponent could cast for 1 mana here? I guess he could go like... obviously it's not strong, but I'm trying to like... figure something out. Dark Ritual... Dark Ritual, Dark Ritual, Dark Ritual, and pass. So does anybody have any idea what the opponent is playing? 3 basic islands is quite uncommon. Like, I think I'm still more inclined to think it's Sneak and Show, but there's a chance that it actually ends up being High Tide. Omnitail 100%. Yeah, I'm also feeling Omnitail. Don't you come back no more. And don't you come back no more, don't you say. Don't you come back no more. And don't you come back no more. Bad fish draw? Oh, that would be such a bad fish draw. Malfok was Preordain. I was actually talking to someone about Malfok with Preordain. Because, okay, this is super interesting. Because if you don't run fetch lands, people generally agree that Brainstorm and fetch land and Malfok is not where you want to be. Assuming you don't play Chalice in the first place, which is like the Malfok list I play. I don't play Chalice. Would Preordain not be better than Brainstorming in that kind of Murfolk list? That's something to think about. Anything we want to change? Like, the only thing I'm looking at is Tireless Tracker. Obviously, if this is High Tide, then Quasari Pride Mage, Oblivion Rings, and Night of Autumns are not going to be great, but we have no way of telling yet. And if it ends up being Show and Tell, like Omnitail, then those are going to be great. Or not great, but very playable. No, I didn't. Like, if I was to play Modern Murfolk, I would love to play it with green. Because what's the name? Tyrant, the 3-mana Murfolk Lord, that's amazing. that we need for our Fs. Kumena. Kumena is so much fun. I'm actually playing that in Arena and I'm winning so much with it. Preordain versus Ponder. I think in that case it's very clearly Preordain. We're gonna keep this. Kumena. Kumena is my guy. Oh, everybody knows Kumena? I had no idea. Lisa and I have been playing that, and it's like, I think we both love the card a lot. Kumena is so much fun. I don't know. Tracker still attacks. Oh, actually, you know what? This might actually be Storm. In which case, he probably takes... Actually, I could see him taking the Hyrek. If it ends up being Storm, then Surgical is definitely going to be better than a lot of cards we boarded in right now. Okay. Oh, well, actually... Oh, no! Oh, wait! Ah, he... He ended up taking the Hyrek. For some reason, I very much assumed he was going to take the Galactic. By the way, guys, tell me, please tell me, should I get Tropico 6? I haven't played, like, those simulations in, like, over 10 years. I really loved Anno 1602 when it came out. And looking at Tropico, I really loved that whole, like... Cold War, pre-Cold War, communist era vibe they're getting. Oh, okay. They're giving us in that game. Kind of want to do that. Maybe I want to run out Dryadaba, I'm not sure. I think I'm gonna run out Gaddock. It's not gonna be great, and eventually they will bounce it, but at least it's providing a little bit of insurance. Actually, not very much, to be honest. Hey, Goblin Lucky. Hey, great, you like that. If you guys have any, like, things you would be interested in us talking about on the podcast, let us know. Also, if you like us, leave us an iTunes on review. Yeah, do that, right? Leave us the entire iTunes on some review page. No, leave us a review on iTunes. We actually got 2 reviews for the last 2 episodes altogether, and that was pretty amazing. Dread of Night? This is a thing? Nobody told me there would be Dread of Knights. Okay. Well, there goes Avid Mind Sensor. And Thalia. And a lot of other things. Huh. Well, there's no point in attacking, right? Huh. Well, this is some real hate coming on now. Thing in the Ice and Dread of Night? We will certainly talk about the new spoiler cards in the next episode. Yes. Yeah, it also works for us a little bit, right? There will be another Anno this year? Is that, oh, people! Somebody told me about that on Twitter. But, you know, Anno doesn't... I love Anno, but I really like that... Like I said, the communist Cold War area, tropical island feeling. Maybe, honestly, like I actually thought about it. Why did I like those streams of Tropico 6 so much? Probably because I can't, like, at least not this year. Maybe next year. Maybe this year as well. Who knows? Probably not this year, though. I really can't afford, like, a proper vacation this year because I need to spend that, like, on consolidating student loans and shit. But, like, watching Tropico 6, I'm really getting that island feeling that I really, really crave right now. That, like, going to, a lonesome island, just chilling, hanging out. And that's what Tropico is giving me when I watch that. Maybe I should just, like, keep watching the streams and be done. I can actually take out the Dread of Night with Persani Pride Mage. This is how we do it. I'm so smart. So, what's the plan? Phoenix Storm? Chaedim. Yes, this is a very special kind of Elsa. So... Anything we wanna do here? I'm just scared they might actually flip the thing in the... Well, in that case, we can get in for free damage pretty much here. For 1 point of free damage. Unless they have, like, Snapcaster, I guess. Tropico 6, Vacation Simulator. Yeah, I'd be down. That actually is a little bit how I feel about the game, yes. So is it gonna be Knight? Knight allows me to play a lot of stuff next turn. But he might actually like flip everything. You know what we're gonna do? We're gonna choke him. Hopefully he won't be able to kill us that way. He won the first game, right? Okay, so there's always gonna be a game 3 if we end up losing here. Goblin, Lecky, any more testing Land Mulligan yet? No. But I enjoyed it very much for Elves, but to be honest, Elves is one of the decks that stands to benefit a lot from it. Overall, I think it's gonna be quite okay. I think it sounds... You know you're into really messed up stuff when you think choking somebody sounds naughty. Not just like hot, but naughty. Like people get kicks out of all kinds of stuff, but thinking it's naughty to choke someone, it's like, oh, I sneaked up behind them and then I choked them and it was so naughty of me. So I fully expect them to bounce our entire board next turn, and then we'll eventually have to come up with a way to beat the thing in the ice. They'll probably replay the Quasari Pride Mage and the Dryad Arbor, take another 7, so at that point we took 14, then next time we block with Quasari Pride Mage. Or actually, I think we get rid of the Dryad Arbor, of the Dread of Night right away and play the Mother of Runes. And then we jump block with Dryad Arbor or something. Actually, we play Teak and jump block with Teak. And then we untap and play Thalia or something. Maybe that's my game plan. Well, I guess that they have ways. Like, they're probably like very dedicated to making the thing in the iceberg. Man in black, man in black. Fenders. I love that song. Man in black. What 19 new things on Twitter? Ever since I got over 2,000 followers, I honestly wonder whether there's like an algorithm on Twitter that like makes your stuff appear on more walls or whatever you call it on Twitter once you reach like certain thresholds, because like it took me a lot of time to get to 2,000 followers on Twitter, and then like in like a month I got 100 more, which is like a 5% increase. It's like pretty a lot. I don't know. I actually have more followers on Twitter than on YouTube by now. On YouTube it's like 1.8k. Twitter is like 2.1k now. I wonder at which point you I'm still very far from that, but at which point do you stop being like a small streamer and become like a medium-sized streamer? In Magic terms. I guess once you get to like 2,000 viewers... No, actually, how many do like the big streamers get? Like, I think you're already like a big streamer in Magic when you get like 1,000 or something. Probably like 700. The 700 threshold where you could consider someone a big streamer? I don't know. So your opponent paid a bunch of life and then passed the turn. We need hate for swamps, by the way. Swamp hate. That sounds like something, like a way of life. Swamp hate. Like, there's people who hate, like, black people, there's people who hate, like, I don't know, swamp people. What would, like, swamp people be? People who live, like in swamps? Are there people in the US living in swamps? I guess in Florida they live in swamps, don't they? Man, I know so little about the US. Karma! Yeah, but karma only deals damage. I want swamps to, like, tap and never untap. I wonder if this is gonna be, like, a ritual. Concurrent viewer, yeah. Or average viewer for a stream, I would say. Average is actually much harder than peak viewer. I mean, there is a card that you can, like, it's from Urza's Saga. You can enchant a swamp, and I think, like, the swamp dies on the next upkeep, and then it comes back to your hand or something. Doesn't it work like that? Pretty sure there's a card. Spreading Algae or something? Okay, what's going on over there? Why did our God of Teak get back to our hand? Oh, because he has Caracas. And now he might have Massacre. Massacre. See, I know how this shit works.
Don't kill!
I've been around, even in the weird interactions. Well, that actually wasn't that hard to see. Oh, when it becomes tap destroyed. Ah, that's how it works. In MTG terms, like 500 plus is a big streamer. That would be good speed if I could ever get there, but probably not with Legacy. But who cares? We get massacred. So now we're really just looking for a way. Ah, Quasari Prime just gone. That's such a problem. I'm not even sure if we want to play Gaddock here. Because Gaddock shuts off Senate. Maybe we really just have to wait. Give in to the hatred, give in to the dark side. Is there anyone in chat who actually has lost games to literally the card Hatred? Like back in my school when I played, like in the 90s, people played turn 1 Raging Goblin, turn 2 Dark Ritual, Hatred, kill you. There's Senate, see? Ooh, smart. let's just get more mana for the mana god. He might actually beat that thing in the ice, who knows? But he might actually just flip him next turn. we might, you know what? Birth? Oh no, this. See, I keep fucking forgetting that this doesn't fly. I once did in top 8, like a really huge tournament in Germany, because I look at this and I'm like, okay, this is like wings, right? 7-8 horror, it's flying, right? It must be flying. So, opponent's like at 1 life. I have like 8 creatures on board, all summoning sick, because I replayed them after he flipped it, and I'm at like 7 life. He makes a desperation attack into me. I'm like, okay, pack it up, boys. Everybody around me is like, I'm like, what? It's like, it doesn't fly, but I'm like, but look at it. It flies. It has wings. It's like, no. Oh, Hatred plus Shadow Creature. That's naughty. That's actually naughty. The funniest part is like when they Hatred for 19 on the creature and you're like, yep, yeah, Lightning Bolt the creature. And then you realize, actually, that was stupid. Okay, let's take 7. It's kind of funny how I think we are still in this game. If we can grow the knights large enough. Oh, this can actually help now. Or can it? I'm gonna run out the Gaddock Teak. Because if he doesn't bounce it, which is like unlikely, but there's a chance. Then we are gonna have more mana next turn. Then we can actually... Can we play... No, we can't play 2 knights next. 1, 2, 3... No, we can't play 2 knights. Unless we draw that. And he doesn't bounce Gaddock. Wings are just there to attract mates. Are you telling me there's gonna be 2 of those soon? Are we playing any... You know what? What's the... Okay, a lot of people know this, but what is the most playable Legacy horror? The most playable Legacy horror. He might actually end up racing that Awoken Horror. No, it takes 2 damage now. Probably takes a knight. If I was him, I would take a knight. Right now. Right here. Right now. Right here. Right now. Oblivion Ring would be amazing. Can we draw Oblivion Ring? Revoker, exactly. You guys got it. By the way, the 3 subs we got today puts us over 60 subscribers again. Thank you so much. Choke! Oh, well, oh no, we already have Choke. So we have to Chump Block next turn. Well, technically we can play Gaddock, but then Gaddock can't Chump Block. That doesn't make sense. Okay. Would be nice if we had Maze of Ith in the deck, but we don't. But maybe there's another way we can work this out. Faceless Butcher, oof. Oh yeah, Ikorid is up there. Ikorid just suffers from being in a horrible deck. The coolest thing I ever did with Ikorid is I tapped it with Merfolk Trickster. So it lost all abilities on the opponent's turn, which also means it loses the end of turn trigger. So it just stuck around to my turn, and then on my turn, I Phantasmal Image copied Icarid, so it had haste, and then I used those to attack for lethal. That was against Eric, it was so much fun. I could have won either way, like with different combinations, it wasn't like the thing that ended up winning the game, but it's how I chose to win the game, that was so much fun. So, you know what, the opponent? I was like, can he even attack here? But I guess he has to attack. It's super unlikely that we get to kill him here on our attack. Like, what would we need to draw? We need to draw, like, we need to have Script Ranger and have, like, a Fetchland, and then that's probably still not enough. Fetchland puts him. Now we're. Actually, do we have Dryad Arbor still in the deck? No, we don't. Ah, unfortunate. What can we draw? So we can turn this into and then draw. Script Ranger would be insane! If we could find Script Ranger, let's find Script Ranger. We're gonna draw an extra card here. Come on. This puts all of our eggs in one basket, but that's fine. We can either find Script Ranger or Oblivion Ring or Senet. Well, not Thalia. Okay. Pack it up. Next game. This is awkward. Do you think he's actually Storm? Like, the Limdu Sword Massacre makes me think... it's probably Omnitail, right? I would think it's Omnitail, but this is really weird. I don't hate swords now. Technically, Surgical screws up his Limdu Sword, but that's not really something I wanna do. So, I could actually see taking out, like, two knights for two swords. Mother's also probably not good. Let's take out like two mothers and play for... because Thing in the Ice is really problematic for us. Not really, but it's quite problematic. It's actually, let's call it quite annoying, because that's what it is. Almost want to play Sword of Fire and Ice against them. Anything else I want to change? Maybe Knight Over Tracker. I don't hate Knight Over Tracker. And then let's go with this. Yes, let's go first. Let's do something crazy. Yeah. Like, actually, you know, I don't hate turn to an Aven Mind Sensor. I just hope we're not getting Dread of Knighted again. Honey, that's true, but that's the same as what I did. Like, what you're suggesting means that we get to look at one more card, and what I did was to look at one more card. I guess the way you suggested it means that we get to activate Knight and draw an extra card. So maybe that would have been better. What? Opponent? Oh, opponent mulliganed to 5 and then had nothing? Okay, let's have some fun. Oh, I almost wanna, you know what, I almost wanna keep up the Aven Mind Sensor. But we're gonna Thalia him. Yeah, that's a good point. Knight would have grown as well. Yeah, 2 looks versus 1, but we have fewer mana. But I think the thing where we get to grow the Knight is actually the most important part. That's true. So, 4 mana. I kind of really want to bring in Script Ranger here. And I also... I really, like, I'd love to get in the Mind Sensor, but I think we just can't afford that. Actually, we can do both. We can get the Mind Sensor and the Script Ranger, which means we don't get to God of Teak. But if we do it like this... What if I do it like this? I don't hate this, actually. Now we get like double protection from Massacre, because we're gonna bounce the Savannah with the Script Ranger. Maybe the opponent really thinks about forcing this. Huh, that would be kind of funny. Yeah, now they can't Massacre because of Teak and because of the lack of planes. Downside is, if the opponent draws a Fetchland, then we can shut it off with Mind Sensor. But it's not even guaranteed we get to shut that one off, and he also needs to top deck that Fetchland. So it's not super likely to happen. And finds another island. Is this gonna be Ponder? Preordain. Next time we still have enough mana for Sigarda. We were getting high. Tell me you went bottom. Two cards in the bottom, perfect. Come on, one time choke. Choke one time. Just one time. Knight. Ugh, I almost wanna get Knight, no. Ah, I want Knight and Sigarda. I want all of those. I just want the power. The power of doing all this crazy stuff. I think I'm actually gonna get Sigarda. Did I get double white? Yeah, I did. Sigarda is gonna hit quite hard. And we're getting it for 5, so he's down to 12. Next turn he's gonna be down to 2. Yeah, Knight couldn't really compete with that. So if they end up having like, well, they can't really cast Show and Tell yet. If they end up having like Show and Tell into Emrakul, we can actually just like take 15. Like we're beating the Emrakul, but not the Cunning Wish kill. But we might still actually also beat the Cunning Wish kill because of Thalia. We might actually be in a really good situation here. I guess maybe just like, just go for the damage. Take the damage, opponent. 5, 10, 11, so he's down to 1. It's gonna be fun. I wish I could deal one more point of damage. Should we play Knight? We probably shouldn't play Knight. We probably should play. You know, almost wanna play Mind Sensor. Maybe that's wrong. Also, kinda wanna play Sylvan Library, but maybe. You know what? Maybe Mind Sensor is the right thing. If he has like a fetch land that allows him to go like Show and Tell, and then do something crazy, I don't know. He could also go Show and Tell Massacre. No, that wouldn't work. He still needs to pay for Thalia. The Thalia tax. Thalia tax screwing over the opponent. Okay, now we have all the hate in the world. Show us what you can do with this. Maybe he just plays Insta end of turn bounce or something. Or fetches are off anyway, right? Why not flash the Mind Sensor? And the problem is, if you flash a Mind Sensor, then you're leaving, like, then you keep Savannah on the board, which allows the opponent to Massacre for 1 mana. Actually, it doesn't, because you have Garruk Teak. So I guess you would need to, like, end of turn bounce Garruk Teak, untap into Swamp, and Massacre. I think it's one of the few ways he could get us if he actually had end of turn bounce into Massacre. And by not flashing in the Mind Sensor, we get to play somewhat around that, I guess. Yeah! Haha! I'm still not sure what the opponent was playing. It was probably Omnitel. Come on, let's get another 4-1. Daddy needs more player points. At this point, I'm having more player points than ever before on Magic Online, I think. Like, I was actually like at a point where I was like feeling a little down because like there was so much shit going on and people had so much hate for Fs. And now, like, I'm getting at least 180, no, at least 120 out of this, so I'm like almost like 220. I think I've never been this high. And this is all courtesy of Maverick. What's my rating right now? 1840 again, see? That's cool. Let's go back to 1900. I've never been to the 2000s, but I've been to the like mid-1900s with elves when elves went like really hot. Maybe I accidentally went to 20, but never noticed. I think Mark, like the person who had the highest rating ever that I've seen with Legacy was like Marcus Druckus. When he played Top Miracles, I think he was close to like 2100 or something. I've been considering sort of Light and Shadow in elves in Maverick, but primarily like the protection from white is really nice in the mirror, and the recursion of the creatures is also really nice. I feel like this is the one thing that the deck is missing, like recursion of creatures. Like, I almost want to play like just a lot of creatures of permanents. I almost feel like I want to play Elfish Witness. Oh, I wish there was Elfish Witness. Eternal Witness. Or some people even play Renegade Rallier. That's something you can also do. But right now, I'm really happy with the deck I said. Acceleration.
I feel the need. The need for
speed. Turn 1 birds. How can anybody ever beat turn 1 birds? He might actually force this. Didn't. Might. Opponent might come back and regret this. Our bird tribal deck is gonna do it, man. Apparently, also our F6 key stopped working again. Genesis? Ooh. But we need to cast it first to make it die. It's gonna be tough. Oh, if this is gonna. Is this gonna be Storm? Please tell me it's Storm. Because then we can still get Garrok next turn. Somebody tell me it's Storm. Come on. Come on. Tell me he's playing Storm. He's like, ah, we got this card. Well. We got two of those. Watch us draw Garrok Teak like a boss now. I don't even want to draw Garrok Teak, to be honest. Opponent might just concede here, please. Do concede. Please. Like, the Swamp is really nice, so it might not be Storm, but he plays like this guy that looks like Naniwa from StarCraft. Garrok Teak.
Combo whore!
Confucius says, Bolt the bird. Always. I like to imagine him saying that like in a very thick American accent. Bolt the bird! Always! Then he goes back to speaking like Mandarin. Ooh, this one's a good one as well. Should we attack here? I think we should attack. It's played uber safe by just casting the Scavenging Ooze. Could be Trix's control, yes. I hope it's not. I'm just playing it really uber safe here. Like, Scalding Tarn definitely makes me a little bit worried. What is it gonna be? What is it gonna be? Fatal Push! Fatal Push! Should've played that Mother, huh? Actually, it's good we didn't play that Mother. Rydex, that last played deck in Goldfish? Well, we're gonna find out. Oh god, this island? What's going on over there? End of turn Brainstorm? That makes me think they wanna play something really good on the next turn for 3 mana. But let's find out. But yeah, right now it actually does look like Grixis Control because of the... How could you like have two different kinds of basic island arts? Like full art and this? It's like, that's not very easy on the eyes. That's actually the one I was expecting when he went end of turn Brainstorm. Let's attack. Kinda wanna run out that Mother, but of course that doesn't do anything. Also, I really want to wasteland him, but I can't really afford to do that. I probably need to, like... I'm sure if I want Tracker. Kinda want Excavator, because it's gonna be so good next turn, but Tracker puts more pressure on him. More pressure on Mrs. Liliana. Mr. Tracker, please do your work. The Epic Thief? I hope it's not. Oh, well, I guess this could have gotten better. Look at this tiny Garrok. Can't hurt anyone. At least you get to play a land from our graveyard now. Or at least I hope we get to do that. Yeah, Liliana of the Last Hope, or the Last Hope. The Last Hope. It's really annoying. But ever since I saw that, you know, that new trailer they did, or that trailer for War of the Spark, I kind of like Liliana now. I never really knew how I felt about Liliana as like a person or planeswalker or like a witch, or is she considered like a witch or a sorceress? Or, I don't know. A warlockess. but now she actually feels like a nice guy. I wonder if they're gonna have Snapcaster here. Snapcaster Fatal Push. I love how Arcan says it. Fatal Push. Good old Fatal Push. Let's take out this and see what they're gonna do. Okay. I'm just gonna play this from the graveyard again. And is this gonna be Fatal Push? Oh, it's gonna be Fatal Push. We have to play a creature deck versus the creature deck. I think the matchup is actually okay. But the opponent is getting... Did he target the Fatal Push? I think he did. So, how do we actually attack here? Probably don't at all. Like, I could attack with a Dryad Arbor, but that's probably bad. But Dryad Arbor is gonna die anyway, so might as well. Wonder if he's gonna take out the excavator. Probably excavator, right? Holding up the hand like an Oath of Liliana. What would Oath of Julian do? If they printed Oath of Julian, would it be like good? What? No! Ah! He took out Garoptik and then my 7 library? Ah. Would have been so sweet with the 7 library. Ghost Quarter would also be super sweet here. But we would still end up losing to Liliana, I guess. And there goes Dry. Actually, you can replay Dry Dabba all the time if you wanted to. It's not really good anywhere though. That was a double kill for sure. Oh wow, now we got our own personal holding mine. Let's holding mine it up. Is there anything we can draw that requires like double? No. No personally pride match in the main. Is this getting us anything? It's not. At least for now. You can actually sit back here, actually should be... I can get Knight next turn, I guess. But even Knight doesn't solve our problems. What does solve our problems? They need to print a green creature that destroys planeswalkers. Like Garuk! Garuk is a creature! Garuk, but as a creature. Bah! Tap Garuk, destroy target permanent. You don't control. Untap Garuk. Garuk. He's like, tap, destroy target permanent you don't control, and like the untap ability, destroy target permanent you don't control. I guess Sigarda can win the match. Check with bargain for 1 Shimano per draw. But we're not even paying life for that. Oh, we're getting hummed. That's bad. Well, we can always top deck what we need, but I'd love to have kept that Sunnet. Even just getting Ooze. Oh, Ooze is already. What? Half of our like creatures are dead. They might end up decking us. What the fuck? Our opponent found the secret attack button. So, what's the plan here? Probably drawing a card. Well, this is actually like we are really just trading this for 1 damage on Liliana. I guess it makes it so that this is gonna be a 2-3 next turn, but that really only just makes it so that Balefoot Strix can attack next turn. So it's not actually the greatest thing to do. See, Ritzend, we are onto something here, are we not? Goblins destroy target walker. Well, that used to exist, right? good old Goblin Mock Fanatic. You guys remember that article about how the damage stacking industry has been really hard with the recession ever since they changed the way it works? That was an amazing article. Ooh, Mother and Thalia, they don't do anything. We can pass the turn. Oh, come on, more of those? You can see it in the Cardboard Life overlay, or sometimes Cardboard Life also sends us a link, but apparently it doesn't want to do that right now. This is gonna be weird. Oh yeah, I'm gonna win this. I mean, we can run out Dryadar, but that doesn't do anything. We just draw an extra card. Should probably do it like this, by the way. It doesn't really matter. At least pre-bought. And another Thalia. The overlay isn't up on your end. Can you see the Cardboard Life overlay? Is it working for everybody else? Can we get some confirmation on Cardboard Life being online? Is it just Legend Advice's client that's not working? Can we make fun of him for that? Well, we could waste, but I don't think we don't really want to. Is this gonna be force? Force pitch something? Probably has to be. Bum bum ba. Sword of Fine Ice would be super sweet. We actually get to attack past all of that shit. They're in ultimate range. You don't see it? What? Why are you guys not seeing Cardboard Life? What are you using? Are you using like the desktop client? Let's play Horizon Canopy. We dead? Yeah, we are pretty much dead here. Yeah, let's make fun of me now instead. Oh, they go for the ultimate. Give me your old set? Okay. It works fine. I'm gonna ship you the money later on, that's cool. Okay, now I think there's really only a way we can win with like a flyer or something. But I guess it helps that, you know, stupid Liliana's gone. I think they actually should have waited a turn, maybe. Netscape Navigator, that's how it works! Oh, we're getting addicted. Oh, that's chip. Oh, I'm always like, oh, I'm such a noob. Whenever I see a new card, I'm like, oh, a new card, oh, amazing! Yeah, Script Ranger is actually a card that can help us here. Because Script Ranger can also attack past the Baleful Strix and carry a Chitter. It's a very weird world where we still get there. Script Ranger even makes it so that we get to play Thalia so we can like block zombies. Or can we? No, we already played a land this turn, right? Show game log. Plays Caracas. Caracas! That's the American sigh. Where do people actually say, like, not say, but sigh? Didn't want to embarrass yourself by telling me it's an explorer. I wonder if you can actually still watch Twitch through, like, real player and stuff. Is there a way? There's probably no way. That's for sure. For sure. So we can attack for one damage and then like untap. For sure. We can equip Sword of Fire and Ice next time, but that doesn't really do anything, does it? So Thalia blocks one of those. Script Ranger blocks like this. And then there's like 2, 4, 6, 8. Okay. Let's go to the second game. I don't see us winning this one. You got surprisingly close. Really surprisingly close. Imagine if you could just like Swords of Plowshares DM then. Tico wins. Tico takes it down. So here we go. Choke, choke, choke. Don't hate Oblivion Ring. Usually I have bought out like three swords. That's a, at least that's what I did the last time I played that match on Saturday. And then what? Was there anything else that changed? Apparently, because it's not working out right now. There's something. One more card I must have removed. Maybe all swords? Did I actually end up removing all swords against them? Oh, Knight of Autumn. Yeah, it looks like what I did last Saturday. I could even see like a one of Sir Checker. But right now, let's go with this. I would love to play first, yes. So we gotta check something. Yeah. Mother is so important in the matchup, like super, super important in the matchup. Tico is Thomas? I didn't know. Thomas actually used to be Mönchinte or something like that. Here we go. Let's see how this works out. I'm like a bard. Another basic. So lucky. I wish we could set him for mother. That would be super sweet. Let's see if he goes to force this. Ah, didn't. Okay. We got another land. Whenever your opponent plays like Strix in the second turn, you always feel like, whew, dodged a bullet. Like, nothing that actually matters. So, I really want to wasteland them. Maybe I should wasteland them. It's just like, you can also get Knight instead. Maybe Knight is where I want to be. Maybe, I want to wasteland them so hard. But I really think I want to wasteland, I want to Knight them. Actually, I don't want to Knight them. I want to Knight us, kind of. Not even sure if I want Knight, like Tireless Tracker might actually be better, now that I think about it. They might faster fill anyway. Okay. Next time we're gonna have, hopefully, Zygarde if they don't like, if they didn't, yeah, okay. Oh, well, that's a problem. I was like, if they didn't him us last turn, then they probably don't him us this turn, but I guess that's what Oblivion Ring is for. Yeah, Oblivion Ring. You know what, I'm actually going to cast it with Wasteland. Because I really, really want to get to 5 mana. Oh fuck, did I actually... Oh no, and I played the land at the wrong spot? Oh, that's really awkward now. anyway, I really want to get to Zygarde next turn. So that's why I'm not Wastelanding them. Zakariot, hey! Awesome, awesome, you made it! Another one of those? Well, guess what we have. But this is the last, unfortunately, this is actually literally the last game. No, there's a chance that we play one more game, right? If we win this one, the Knight. Almost want to wasteland then again. But I also really want to play the Noble Hierarchs to make sure that I have Zygarde next turn. Please don't have Force now. Okay. All of those are gone. And this gives us Zygarde next turn. It's actually not that great because it can't attack past Baleful Strix, but it's going to be Zygarde. That's amazing sound, right? Oh, well, there goes Zygarde. You know what would be amazing to draw? The snake. The snake that's not actually a snake. Okay. Excavator, come on, one time. Come to me, Excavator. Well, you're not Excavator, but we can draw Excavator. Oh, that's a nice, nice one. Let's get this one going. And I think I should actually run out the Chitter, because otherwise there's a chance they might discard it. Do we even want Chitter? We probably want Chitter. Like, I could actually see wanting Sword of Fire Knights, but I'm super scared they might discard it. So I'd rather go with the Chitter here. Or as a friend of mine says, Jitte. Jitte. or like the Japanese say chita, or the worst thing that people say chite, like even shit I can accept, but chite, like bleh. Oh man, I'm not even sure what I want to do here. They probably don't have Krosagans command. Kolagan's command they would have played to make me discard my card, so I don't think they have Kolagan's command. They might have a removal spell though. Knight doesn't really do much. I think I'm gonna try to get the snake. If I get the snake, then I can either double wasteland them or equip Chitta. And then I'm also gonna have my own Horizon Canopy online. Could have wastelanded them first to play around fetch add, play around Forcefall. I probably should have done that. let's see. Anything I want to change? What do we want to attack here? I guess we want to attack the one thing that's not an island here. And then maybe top deck choke. That would be sick. It's gonna be Snapcaster? Nah. Oh, you know what? Attack a player, sacrifice a creature. Would have been insane if we had Sigarda. Yeah, Mother is fine. Mother is a good card. Do we actually have to attack here? We don't even need to attack here. I mean, we forced the trade, so maybe it's not that bad. We can also, like, just play Mother next turn. Maybe it's actually safer to not attack. Feels weird to not attack though, because we're missing out on two Chitta counters. Now let's not attack. Could be wrong, but let's do it like this. We are already screwed up by not wastelanding before. Like I was even thinking about it, but then I got so caught up in like what else we wanted to do, and whether we wanted to like actually play a land from graveyard and equip Chitta. But overall, we went for like mid the road play, and that ended up being by far the worst. Gonna minus a Mother. Minus and Stormforge seems bad value wise. Oh, now he can actually make us discard the Mother. He wants to keep us the one card in hand? He must have some really good card in hand. Huh. That's interesting. He must have some really good card in hand if he wants to do it like this. Do I attack here? Definitely gonna play the Knight, and then he's probably gonna go minus and chase again. I think I'd rather... Feels weird to not attack there. Might be incorrect. Put me down, put my feet back on the ground. Better Sky would be a sweet thing to draw. Snapcaster, say Kolagan? Oh, there's no Kolagan's command. That's why Fuddle Push makes sense. Oh, the snake would have been so sweet. We wasteland there, we get the snake, we wasteland again, the game is over, yeah. That would have been sweet. Maybe they had something to pitch for us. Who knows? I think at this point, unless we draw Choke, then there's maybe a chance. But unless we don't literally draw a choke, I think it's pretty safe to concede here. Okay, and we get the wasteland. Okay, well, can't always win them all. That was the match, right? So we went 3-1. No, 3-2. We're definitely gonna open that last treasure chest that we're gonna get from this. Once Magic Online has proceeded like us losing here. So let's check this one out. Ba 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 ba. Let's get something good. When I go 3-2, I always hope that there's something good. Well, this is already worth more than the entire treasure chest. And then we get Lava Hounds on top. 8th edition rare. I hear 8th edition is like pretty influential in modern. When it enters the battlefield, it deals 4 damage to what? That's bad. It has haste, but it attacks you first before attacking the opponent. Anyway. This is gonna be it. I hope you all liked what you saw today. We had a lot of fun with Green Up Everick. Deck is incredibly legit. Had we not like screwed up here, it would have been like double 4-1. So if you like this, give me a follow on Twitter, give me a follow on Twitch at itsjulian23, on check out itsjulian.com. Give me a follow here so you can get notifications whenever I go live. Okay, where's my thing that I have to read every time I finish my stream? No. It was a staple during Mirage Standard. Oh, that was right before I started playing, so I don't know. So here we go. And I'm gonna stream again probably on Wednesday, so make sure to check that one out. And now I'm gonna play some I can't even remember the name. Seku, whatever. That new ninja game that's so much fun on the PlayStation. So thanks a lot for tuning in and see you next time. Bye bye.